Charger Lab got a super performance GaN charger, launched by the well-known brand Anker. The product is available on the Apple Store. It has four USB-C output ports, and the USB-C 1 port supports 140 watts PD 3.1. The other three ports also support an output power of 100 watts, and the total output power of multiple ports can reach 150 watts, which can charge multiple devices at the same time. Anker, product appearance, name, and selling points are printed on the front of the box. The back is printed with selling points and application scenarios for charging laptops, phones, and headphones at the same time. The specs info is printed on the side. The box contains the charger and some documents. The shell is made of white PC flame retardant material with a matte surface treatment. Anker is printed on the front center. The spec info is printed on the input panel. Model is A2655. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts 50 or 60 Hz 2.3 amps. The maximum output power is 150 watts. It comes with a foldable plug. The plastic sheets of the four USB-C ports are all blue. Its size is about 62.84 by 75.22 by 30.89 millimeters. Compared with the Apple 140 watts charger, it has an obvious size advantage. The weight is about 306.3 grams. ChargerLab Power's EKM003C shows the USB-C 1 can support PD 3.1, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp charging protocols. And it has five fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 5 amps, and 28 volts 5 amps. It also has a set of AVS, which is 15 to 28 volts 140 watts. The other three ports have the same compatibility and all support PD 3.0, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amps charging protocols. They also have the same fixed PDOs, which are four fixed PDOs, 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, and 20 volts 5 amps. Next, let's take it apart. Remove the input end shell. The shell is ultrasonically welded. The interior of the charger is filled with potting compound to improve heat dissipation. There are copper plates and aluminum foil stuck on the inside of the case to help dissipate heat. At the same time, high-temperature resistant insulating tape is also attached. The PCBA module is filled with potting compound. The components on the front of the PCBA are very compactly arranged. The PFC boost inductor is covered with a heat sink, and other components are all wrapped with insulating tape. The back of the PCBA is equipped with a PFC controller, PFC MOSFET, optocoupler, SMDY capacitor, and MCU. There are three small PCBs at the input end of the PCBA module. The small PCB in the middle is equipped with a time delay fuse, common mode choke, and safety X2 capacitor. The time delay fuse is from Betafuse. 5 amps 250 volts. The safety X2 capacitor on the back is from DGCX. 0.1 microfarad. The other gray safety X2 capacitor is also from DGCX. 0.33 microfarad. The two bridge rectifiers are from PY and Adopt D3K package. 8 amps 1000 volts. The MPP film filter capacitor is also from DGCX. 1 microfarad 450 volts. The PFC controller is from Southchip. The PFC MOSFET is from CR Energy and adopts DFN 8x8 package. This Cascode Core GaN device uses CR Energy depletion process technology with a withstand voltage of 650 volts, a transient withstand voltage of 800 volts, and an arm resistance of 110 milliohm. It has an extremely low gate charge. The PFC synchronous rectifier is from PC Semic. The two blue high voltage filter electrolytic capacitors are from IMIN. 420 volts 56 microfarad. The switching power supply master control chip is from DK. The resonant capacitor is from DGCX. 0.47 microfarad 250 volts. The capacitor that powers the master control chip is from YMIN. 63 volts 22 microfarad. The transformer uses a TQ27 magnetic core. The Evolite EL1019 optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The three SMDY capacitors are all from KFAT. The blue Y capacitor is from DGCX. The transformer is connected to the synchronous rectifier small PCB and wrapped with tape. There is a synchronous rectifier controller on the front of the small PCB. There are two synchronous rectifiers on the other side. The synchronous rectifier controller marked with IBHJP is from MPS. The two synchronous rectifiers marked with G100 and 045G are from HR Micro. The solid capacitor for output filtering is also from YMIN. 35 volts 220 microfarad. Another solid capacitor is wrapped with insulating tape. 35 volts 680 microfarad. This is the third solid capacitor. 35 volts 220 microfarad. The MCU is from ChipC. It is used for the intelligent distribution of multiport output power. There are buck inductors of the four secondary buck circuits and secondary filter solid capacitors on the front of the output small PCB. On the back, there are buck protocol chips with four secondary buck circuits, synchronous buck MOSFETs, and output V-bus MOSFETs. The four circuits are independent of each other. The secondary step-down circuit control chip of the USB-C1 port is from iSmartware. The two synchronous buck MOSFETs and the output V-bus MOSFET are from Elepic. This is the step-down inductor. 4.7 microhenry. The secondary step-down solid capacitor for output filtering at the USB-C1 port is also from YMIN. 35 volts 220 microfarad. The other three USB-C ports have the same secondary step-down circuit schemes. The step-down protocol chips of the USB-C234 port are all from iSmartware. The two synchronous buck MOSFETs and the output V-bus MOSFET of the three power components are also from Elepic. These are the buck inductors of the three buck circuits. The three secondary filter solid capacitors are also from YMIN. 25 volts 220 microfarad. Here is the component list of the Anker 150 watts 4 ports GaN charger for your convenience. After taking it apart, we found it uses PFC plus AHB power architecture design. In addition, the PCBA module is filled with potting compound to improve heat dissipation, and heat sinks are added to the bridge rectifier, PFC boost inductor, and even the shell to help dissipate heat. Whether it is the overall or the details, the materials and workmanship of this product by Anker are quite good. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.